Hi everyone. So in our last tutorial video about how to write a PRD and how to use select and edit to edit your UI elements, we've built this beautiful sleep tracker for myself and for my friends as well. Solo Builder is not only able to build web front end, it can also take care of a lot of your backend logic and service API integrations. So in today's video, let's walk you through how to use Solo Builder to wire up your full stack application with Supabase integration. We'll also walk you through how to use Solo Builder to write a clean technical design doc before starting your backend service implementations. Let's get started. So for adding a backend service, we can't just ask Solo Builder to build an entire backend with one single prompt. We have to do it step by step. So for me, I think the most important thing right now is to add a user profile to the sleep tracker so that I'm able to actually sign in with my email account and be able to manage my personal sleep trackers. So in my prompt, I just tell Solo Builder to start building the backend service for the sleep tracker, which includes a user profile so that users are able to sign up and also manage their own schedules. Let's send it to Solo. Okay, so after we send it to Solo Builder, you can see that it's actually analyzing the current project structures to see if there is existing documentations for any backend services. So right now we don't have one. So it's actually writing a technical requirement first to figure out what it needs to build for the backend. Let's turn on the flow and follow the steps Solo is taking. All right, looks like it's actually changing the PRD, which is a very, very good practice first to update my requirements in the product requirement doc first. Okay, now it's actually creating a technical architecture design. I will sit here and wait for a bit to let Solo finish this part first. Okay, looks like Solo just finished writing the technical design doc. Let's take a look. So it starts with an architectural design. Okay, it also defines the APIs and the parameters that it's going to use. Looks like it's a pretty clean doc that I would expect from a well-organized, good engineer. Okay, it also draws the diagram and the data models. And I think everything looks good. Well, we can also actually like how we did in PRD doc, we can also edit and write an update on the technical design doc ourselves. I want to start by building the user authentication flow first. But before we get started to letting Solo do the work, I want to first show the integration tab, which is the latest tab that we just added to Solo. So in the integration tab, you can actually see the Supabase integration panel under it. After you click the Supabase integration inside your profile, you'll see this page, and you can just click connect and authorize the access to your Supabase. So now that you can see, besides Vercel, we have Supabase also connected under our Tray account. So once you're done with your Supabase authentication, if you go to the integration tab and click on the create projects, it will redirect you to the Supabase dashboard to create your new project. Let's just name it as a sleep tracker. And give it a password. Let's get back to our Tray IDE. Now you can see our new project sleep tracker got created. And we can connect so that Solo Builder has the context of which database you are actually using with this project. Cool. Now that I want to continue with building the authentication flow with Solo Builder. Okay, So it gets started to building this authentication flow. And Solo Builder starts by creating its own task list. And what's good about task list is that now with this little card, we have the context into what steps the Solo Builder is actually taking in doing these implementations. Also for the model itself, this task list is also able to break down a very vague prompt into executable steps to be able to better complete its work. And now I can even just hide the entire extended panel and then switch on to working on something else. And now I'll just skip the process on waiting for Solo Builder to complete its implementation for our sleep. So now let's test the signup logic for our sleep tracker. I want to create account. Okay, let's check the email. Looks like I just got the email for me to confirm my signup.